What's good with the YouTube? It's your boy Rojo, and this is the Convict's Perspective, man. And you know the things that are going on right now. You know, we dropped it eight days ago or so about the MS and the MA. Got little issues, man. Well, check this out, man. We got something that just released 3 days ago out of the United States Attorney's Office, Western District of Virginia, Department of Justice. MS-13 gang member pleads guilty to conspiring to kill rival Mexican mafia inmate. The last of five federal prisoners charged with conspiring to kill a fellow inmate at United States Penitentiary Lee, a high-security federal prison for male inmates, pleaded guilty today to federal charges related to the attempted murder. Carlos Alfredo Almonte, a.k.a. Rabioso, 31, pleaded guilty today to conspiracy to commit murder, attempt to commit murder, assault of an inmate with a dangerous weapon, and possession of a weapon by an inmate. Just last week, Julio Angel Chavez, Angel Moreno Gavera, and German Hernandez each pleaded guilty for their roles in the attempted murder of fellow inmate and victim, known only as AZ, on January 15th, 2020. So this is when all this stuff really started popping off, man. And there's more to it. And I'll get to it after. Morris Alex Flores pleaded guilty in June of 2021. To guarantee the civil rights of federal prisoners, they must be able to serve their sentences in environments that are safe and humane and without the fear of violence. My office will continue to prioritize the prosecution of violent crimes that occur against those in federal custody, especially at USP Lee, United States Attorney Christopher R. Kavanaugh said today. I'm grateful to the efforts of the FBI and the Federal Bureau of Prisons for their work on bringing these five violent offenders to justice, protecting the civil rights of every citizen. Investigating violations thereof is a priority for the FBI, regardless of the individual status in the community. Special Agent in Charge Stanley M. Mador of the FBI's Richmond Division said today, the victim being incarcerated did not lessen the importance of this investigation, as we work closely with our partners to ensure those responsible for his death were brought to justice. According to court documents, Almonte, Flores, Chavez, Hernandez, and Guevara, all members of the international crime gang MS-13, attacked AZ, a member of the rival Mexican mafia, on January 15th of 2020 with the intent to commit murder. Flores and Gavera attacked AZ in his cell with metal shanks while Almonte, Chavez, and Hernandez blocked the cell door and fought off other inmates who attempted to interfere with the attack. AZ sustained multiple stab wounds, but ultimately survived the attack. The Federal Bureau of Investigation and the Bureau of Prison investigated the case. Now, you know, we told you, you know, about this that happened at Lee and stuff, and there was varying accounts of whether the individual was actually killed or if he survived. That's right from the Department of Justice. So, you know, I assume it to be pretty accurate, you know, as it's an official court document. But nonetheless, man, this is a, you know, it's still a developing situation, man. And what I had heard, too, is there was a case, you know, in Southern California that the MS participated in where a young woman was assaulted in a devious manner, you know, by members of the MS. And this was a contributing factor to the ongoing, you know, conflict in a sense, because from what I gathered from a few sources was that they were asked to take care of their own dirt, meaning, you know, their people, you know, that fly under the MS, you know, their brand, you know what I'm saying, for lack of a better word, they were asked to take care of it and they refused. So, you know, the policy with, you know, most Latino groups is that any kind of offenders of that nature, they got to go immediately. And, you know, refusing to do so and protecting these individuals, you know, under the MS brand, you know, was perceived as a disrespect for, you know, the individuals that represent the 13 down south in general. So, you know, that contributed to a lot of problems, man. You know, this is an ongoing thing. You know, we broke it to you here, you know, about how they moved the MS members and the traditional Serranos. They separated them in the Bureau of Prisons. And we also broke it to you, man, when we received word that the MS had a green light on federally, state streets. So that's it's going to be one of those stories that continue to develop. Who knows where it's going to go. You know, we've offered our theories, you know, me and Flacco, our perspectives, you know, about how the MS that's from Southern California will continue to function under the major umbrella down there. You know, that's what I truly believe. However, you never know what direction this is going to take. A lot of people have discussed how, you know, national pride, such as Salvadorian pride, et cetera, might come into play, you know, with the group tending to stand by their own of the same nationality, so to speak. This is something only time's going to be able to figure out, man, because you never know what's being discussed. You know, there's big homies everywhere from down the way. They might have a different view on things than, you know, people who aren't actively involved 100%, man. We're just going on common sense on how things will probably have to play out for everybody to save face. You know, so over the next few months, man, there's going to be a lot more to this, undoubtedly. And hopefully we can bring that to you as they develop and continue to offer all the breaking news that we do. It's your boy Rojo, it's a Comics Perspective. We'll holler at you guys in a little bit with another backer.